गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल बी कंटिन्यू विद आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स. सपोज दिस इज आ एरिया, सपोज, एंड 20 इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइंस आर क्रॉसिंग थ्रू दिस एरिया. सपोज दैट मीन्स इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइंस आर क्रॉसिंग थ्रू दिस एरिया, वी विल कॉल इट एज अ क्वान्टिटी. सो दिस विल बी नोन एज अ न्यू क्वान्टिटी. वट इज द नेम ऑफ दैट क्वान्टिटी? फ्लक्स. The quantity name is electric flux. So what this electric flux will give? Electric field linked with the area. So what it will donate? Electric field linked with the area. Suppose this is an area, okay. So this area is suppose A, and E is the electric field linked. This area is placed normal to the electric field, and total E is the electric field that is linked with this area. Area is placed normal to electric field. Total area is A, and total electric field linked with area is A. The plane of the area, what is this plane? Suppose this is a copy. This is a copy. This is its plane. So suppose electric field lines, if they are crossing in this way, so pen is pointing in the direction of electric field lines. So we are placed the area normal to the electric field lines. Plane of this area is normal to electric field. So we have to place the area like this. So E is the electric field. If we means do the product, take the product of electric field and the area, total area multiplied with electric field, it will give us the flux, and flux is donated by phi. So flux is the product of the electric field and the area placed perpendicular to the electric field. So flux definition is product of electric field intensity. So E is electric field intensity and area of surface, which surface placed perpendicular to electric field. So perpendicular to electric field. So this is a concept. So E is phi. Phi is known as electric flux. So this is electric flux, phi. Okay. Suppose this is the electric field. Okay. But now the surface is not placed perpendicular. It is inclined. Okay. This surface is inclined. It is making angle theta. Suppose it is making angle theta. Earlier it was like this, na? Like this. But now it has tilted and it is tilted at angle theta. Okay. It is angle tilted at angle theta. Earlier it was normal, na? Now it has tilted to angle theta in the direction of electric field, with the direction of electric field. So this angle is also known as theta, alternate angles. So this will have the two components, na? It is making angle theta. So this component is known as, so this is a area. First, this is A. It is having total area. This length is having total area A. And this area is making angle theta with the electric field. So now this component is known as A cos theta. What is this length called? This length. what is this length called? A cos theta. Now, not the whole area, electric field lines are not falling on the whole A area. They are falling on the A cos theta length. In earlier case, all the electric field lines, they are means passing through area A, but now they are passing through length A cos theta. They will not pass through all the area. They will pass through this length of the area. Means now the length through which electric field lines are passing, it is known as A cos theta. So total electric field, suppose it is passing E. Okay. And what is the length in which electric field lines are passing? We will assume like this. Now the surface is tilted, because in practical all we are not having the surface that is placed perpendicular to the electric field. In practicality, suppose now the surface is tilted at angle theta, that means the area is making angle theta with the electric field, is tilted with. Now the surface is tilted at angle theta with electric field. So length of surface through which electric field lines are passing, is A cos theta. Okay. So now the electric field is passing. So what is the formula of flux? Flux is electric field into area through which electric field lines are passing. Area through are passing. So now they are passing through A cos theta, because this is the perpendicular length. Now this is the length of area that is perpendicular to electric field as it is tilted. So the electric field lines, they are not passing through this length. Now they are passing through this perpendicular length, because now the surface is tilted. So into E is equal to 5. So this is a area of a surface and this is electric field. AB cos theta. A dot B. So E dot A. Where A is the area vector of surface. Suppose if this is surface, na? Suppose this is surface. The area vector is always perpendicular to the plane of surface. This is known as the plane of surface. The area vector will always be perpendicular to the plane of surface. You note down this point, area vector, it will be perpendicular to the plane of surface. So now the case has changed. Because in practical situations, we will not get the surface perpendicular to the electric field. It would be tilted. If it would be tilted by angle theta, so what is the value of electric field? E A cos theta. E dot A. So the flux linked with a surface that is tilted at an angle theta with the direction of electric field is phi is equal to E A cos theta. Now we would consider a case in which electric field is not uniform. At all points of the surface, okay, that means electric field will be. So now let us consider a case where electric field is not uniform at all points of the surface. So this is surface. Here electric field is different, here different, here different. here different, here different, here different, like this. Suppose this is the concept, electric field due to source charge, like this is the surface. So what you will take, you will break the surface into small surface elements. DS, okay, you will break whose area vector is this thing. Suppose this is a surface, the area vector is like this, normal to the plane of surface. So this is the surface. So this is the surface you are breaking. This is DS pose. Okay, this is the direction of electric field. Here also DS. Here also small DS. You will consider only this DS. Where is the area vector DS? Normal to the surface. Normal is like this. Here this is the direction of DS. Consider a small, means consider a surface, break this surface into small surface elements DS. It is made of so many DS, and this DS having an area vector, this DS, small surface is having area vector DS. So this area vector, it is making a angle theta with the electric field. You will write this as a theory. DS is making theta angle with electric field. Okay, like this. The surface is like this. The electric field is in this direction and surface is in this direction. Okay, like this theta. So E will get broken into two components like this. So which component of E is acting towards DS? E cos theta. Okay, so E cos theta, electric field intensity is passing through this DS. Okay, now so E cos theta is the electric field which is passing through this DS surface. So what will be there? It will be a flux. We will get the flux, but we will get, we are calculating for small surface now, so we will get the small flux. So we will write this, E cos theta is passing through small surface element DS. Okay, so this, that means E cos theta is passing through small surface element DS. So this is the definition, product of the electric field and the surface area, that is known as flux, but we will get the small flux. So we will integrate this small flux through whole surface. We will get the total flux. Okay, like this. So we will integrate this E cos theta ds. So phi is equals to integration E ds cos theta. So what is this? A b cos theta, a dot b, a dot b is equal to phi. So total electric flux is like this. So what is this? This is the surface integral of electric field over that surface. So this is the concept. That means we will calculate it for this ds also, this ds also, this ds also. We will do the integration and it would be for all the surfaces. So it is flux linked to a surface, total flux
linked to a surface, which surface placed in electric field is surface integral, that is equals to is surface integral of electric field, which electric field linked with that surface or linked or passing through that surface. So this is a concept. Make the notes as I am explaining, make the notes. So this is case, special case, practical case means electric field will not be uniform. Here electric field will be different at all points of surface. So what we will do, we will break, this is total surface, suppose S total surface. We will break the surface into small surface elements, ds, and so many ds. And there is an area vector of every surface, and this ds is having area vector, suppose ds, which is perpendicular to the surface like this ds. It is making angle theta with the electric field. So which component of E is acting along ds? E cos theta. So E cos theta is the electric field lines which are passing through ds. And the electric field lines which is passing through our area is known as flux. We are calculating for small ds, we will get the small flux. In order to get the calculate the whole flux, we need to integrate the for the whole surface. E cos theta for whole surface, surface integration. So A B cos theta, A dot B. A dot B. So the new definition of electric flux is in practical conditions is total flux linked to a surface in electric field is surface integral of electric field passing through that surface. Linked with that surface or passing through that surface. So now we will consider the special cases. Suppose the plane of surface is perpendicular to electric field. Okay, so this is surface. So the surface area vector is ds in this direction, normal to the surface. The area vector is always normal to the surface and E is in this direction. Okay, so what will be the flux? Flux is surface integration of E ds cos theta. So what is the angle between E and ds? Ds is also in this direction, E is in also direction, theta is 0. So put phi is equals to E ds cos 0. What is cos 0? 1. E ds is phi. Okay. And you will do the integration of E, integration of ds. Suppose total surface is area is S, E into S. So maximum flux will pass through the surface if the plane of the surface is normal to the electric field. We will take a condition if plane of surface is normal to electric field. So what we will attain? Maximum flux will pass through the surface. Maximum flux will pass through the surface. Okay, like this. Second, case number second. If the plane of the surface is in the direction of electric field, suppose this is the direction of electric field, and the plane of, suppose this is surface, okay, and the plane of this surface is in the direction of electric field, so area vector is perpendicular to the plane of the surface at 90 degree. If the plane of the surface is in the direction of electric field, and area vector is always normal to the plane of the surface. So we are taking consider if plane of surface means first of all the surface is like this it was like this. Electric field, now we have placed like this. If electric field is going in the direction of pen, we have placed the plane of surface in the direction of electric field. So this is the direction of electric field, this is the plane of surface, and this is area vector. Area vector is like this, normal to the plane of surface, like this. So if plane of surface is in the direction of electric field, so what is the flux length? Theta becomes 90 degree between E and ds. So phi is equal to total surface E ds cos theta, total surface integration cos theta. Put theta 90 here, E ds cos 90 becomes 0, so the flux link is 0. Okay, so flux link is 0. So all the electric field lines will pass like this, they will not pass through the surface. So flux length is 0. So no electric field line will pass through the surface because the plane of the surface is in the direction of electric field. So this is our second case. So flux is equals to electric field into area. So what is the unit of SI unit of flux? SI unit. So F is equals to QE, we have already done. Electric field is equals to force upon charge, electric field. Unit of electric field is Newton upon Coulomb. And unit of area is meter square. So put here Newton upon Coulomb into meter square. So what is the SI unit? Newton meter square per Coulomb. So flux is equals to Newton meter square per Coulomb square. So this is the SI unit of flux. Okay, so what is the dimensional formula? Now next topic is dimensional formula of flux. So phi is equals to electric field into area. So what is electric field? We have already done F is equal to QE and E is equals to F upon Q, force upon charge. Force upon charge into area. Charge is equal to current into time. Current into time. Okay. So force, you know, mass into acceleration, you know the dimensions of force. The dimensions of force are, you know dimensions of force, you know the dimension of area, you know the dimension of current, ampere, A into T, area, meter square. Calculate the dimensions of force is equals to mass into acceleration. Acceleration means change in velocity upon time. Velocity upon time. Velocity means displacement upon time. Displacement means length upon time into time, time square. So the dimension of force is mLt minus 2. You know the dimension of force mLt minus 2. Current is ampere, area is meter square, time is t. You can calculate the dimensions of flux. Okay, like this. Note this, electric flux is a scalar quantity. Magnitude only, no direction. So you know that when the plane of surface is perpendicular to electric field, then maximum flux is linked with the surface. If the plane of surface is parallel, no flux is linked, you know. If it's a closed surface, total of flux linked with the closed surface is E dot ds, surface integration of E dot ds. You know that, we have already done that. But remember, important thing is it is a scalar quantity, it is not a vector quantity. Flux is equals to E into area. We have already done in the beginning, flux is equal to E into area. Product of the electric field and the area placed perpendicular to the electric field. So next topic is electric flux linked to a closed surface. So what is this electric flux linked to a closed surface? First of all, that means suppose you are having a football at your home. You place a bulb here inside the football. The light must remain within the bulb. Then only we can call it as a closed surface. Okay. So if the light is escaping from this circular ball, it is not in, means like an enclosed surface. Suppose here it is a gap, it is not a closed surface. So this is an example of a closed surface, this is example of closed surface. A box, a sphere, and this is cylinder is an example of a closed surface. You know that a cylinder is made of three surfaces. One is first, this is first is plane surface, and this is curved surface, and again this third is first surface is plane surface, second surface is curved surface, third surface is plane surface. So you know that that means the cylinder is having three surfaces. One is plane surface, curved surface. Suppose this cylinder is placed in electric field. So this plane surface will make different angle with the electric field. This curved surface will make different angle with the electric field. This plane surface will make different angle with the different electric field. So different surfaces, they make different angle with the electric field. What is the general formula that we have obtained? Surface integration of EDS cos theta. We will calculate for every surface like this. Suppose this is a cuboid having six surfaces up down like your room, this side and six sides are there. You look at your room, four walls, one top, one bottom. So if it is placed in electric field, each surface will make different angle with the electric field. So we will calculate closed surface means we will calculate the flux linked. Suppose this is a cuboid. So I'm just getting this surface only. This surface I'm getting. So the area vector of this surface is this. So suppose it is electric field is in this direction, it is making some different angle. If I take the top portion, the area vector is perpendicular to the plane of the surface upward, electric field is in this direction. So it is making different angle. So we will calculate flux for each surface. We will calculate the flux for first surface also. E ds cos theta. Suppose for this first surface ds is 1. Like this. So ds, we calculate in ds. We will calculate flux for second surface also. We will calculate flux for third surface also. And go on, so many. So I will say it as a for closed surface. This is a closed surface integration. Closed surface integration means integration of all the surfaces, then add up. Closed integration or closed surface integral. EDS cos theta. We will get the flux linked with the closed surface. So our topic name is electric flux linked to a closed surface. So the electric flux linked to a closed surface is we will add all the flux linked to each surface of that closed surface. So for closed surface, the formula comes to be closed surface integration E dot ds cos theta E dot ds. So this is the formula of flux for a closed surface. The flux linked to a closed surface in which electric field is there, that is closed surface integral of EDS cos theta. Closed surface integral E dot ds. So this is the formula you have to remember. This we will use in next theorem we are going to discuss. So this is the flux linked with a closed surface. Suppose this is a closed surface and Q is the charge inside this closed surface. Due to charge Q, electric field lines will be there and there will be so many electric field lines. So we will take a small surface of this closed surface ds, and the area vector of this ds is like this. Electric field is in this direction. We know that, we have already done that, the total flux inside a closed surface is closed surface integration of E dot ds. So Q is the charge inside, suppose. The Gauss says that if Q is the charge inside closed surface, the total flux linked with the closed surface is 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge that is placed inside that closed surface. Gauss law says that the total flux is 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge. 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge that is placed in that closed surface. Says the flux linked with a closed surface is 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge enclosed within that closed surface, because charge will be there na inside the closed surface. If charge will be there, then only the electric field lines will be there, and due to that electric field lines only we are getting the concept of electric flux, because electric flux is the electric field lines that is crossing through some surface, number of electric field lines. So we have already obtained this formula, closed surface integration of E dot ds, that is the flux linked with the closed surface, and Gauss says Q upon epsilon naught. Gauss says total flux linked is this, we have calculated by formula total flux linked is this, so they both are equal. So the total flux linked with the closed surface is phi E Q upon epsilon naught, Gauss says, or closed integration of E dot ds. You know what is ds, area vector of surface. How E dot ds closed surface is coming on, I have taken the example of cubed, and I have given the cubed as in 6 faces, and each surface will have different flux linked with it. We will add all the fluxes and we will get the closed surface integration of E dot ds. So this is the total flux linked with the closed surface. But the Gauss says, if Q is the charge inside the closed surface, 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge enclosed within that surface, that is the total flux. So I will combine this concept also, and I will combine this concept also, and I will say the either the value of flux linked with the closed surface is equals to Q upon epsilon naught or E dot ds. So this is a Gauss theorem. This is the definition of Gauss theorem. Total flux linked with the closed surface is 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge placed in that closed surface. So Gauss theorem is only valid for closed surfaces, means it is not applicable to open surfaces. The charge that is placed inside a closed surface, it can be single or it can be multiple charges. Remember that. Suppose a charge Q is placed outside. So it will have its electric field, and this Q will also have its electric field. So the flux inside this closed surface will not be affected by the electric field of this Q charge. So Q will not get affected by bigger Q, which is outside. So flux will not get affected inside closed surface by the presence of some charge that is outside that closed surface. Okay. So net flux is due to charges inside the closed surface. Use this concept. Flux depends on, Gauss theorem is this, flux depends on two things, epsilon naught, we are using this concept from Coulomb's law, and electric field intensity. Flux depends on epsilon naught and electric field. So epsilon naught we are using in Coulomb's law, and electric field we are using in, we have done the derivation of electric field also. It is an inverse scalar law. It depends on 1 upon r square. And Coulomb's law also depend on 1 upon r square. It also follows inverse scalar law. flux depends on epsilon naught that comes in Coulomb's law. Flux depends on electric field that comes in, that also follows the inverse square law. Due to that, the shape of Gauss theorem is Q upon epsilon naught. So we say that Gauss theorem follows inverse square law. We will prove in the coming lectures. So remember this thing, Gauss theorem, it follows inverse square law. Due to, as the Coulomb law and both electric field are following the inverse square law, due to this, the shape of Gauss is like this, Q upon epsilon naught. We are going to prove. So we have done the derivation of Gauss theorem. We have done the electric flux linked with a closed surface. We have done some properties of Gauss theorem. It applies to closed surface. Charge can be single or multiple charges. If the charge is present outside, it will not have effect on the flux linked with the closed surface. Gauss law is an inverse square. So this is first part of this lecture. We will record another lecture. You will get the two means all the lectures in the same sequence.